So we are discussing about the types of flows. In open channel. So the first one, steady. And steady flow. So steady flow means all the flow properties. Okay, so flow properties like velocity, discharge, and duration. So do not change with respect to time. Okay. So what is the meaning? So if the flow properties do not change at different time intervals, it means, so if this is a channel, okay, and at this section, okay, but if we consider one section, so at time t equal to 0 seconds, so t1, say the velocity is say 2 meter per second. At time t2 is equal to 10 seconds, velocity v2 is equal to 4 meter per second. Okay. So what is the change in velocity with respect to time? So you can write v2 minus v1 by t2 minus t1, that is equal to dou v by dou t. So how much you get? 2 by 10. So at roughly about 0.5. Okay. So it means whenever do not change, right? So the velocities do not change. It means you get same 2 meter per second. Okay. So that is the meaning of do not change. So at each and every time interval, the flow properties do not change. So you get 2 minus 2, 0. Okay. So it means, so dou v by dou t is equal to 0. Okay. So similarly for all parameters. So similarly for all parameters like discharge, acceleration, the properties do not change respect to time. So you can write 2q by dou t equal to 0. You can write dou a by dou t equal to 0. Okay. So all these properties do not change with respect to time. Okay. So I hope you understood this. Right. Next. That is steady flow. And what is unsteady flow? So it's just reverse of the. First one, steady flow. So here the flow property changes with respect to time. Okay. So it means at a time t1 is equal to 0 seconds, we have velocity v1 equal to say 2 meter per second. At a time t1 equal to 10 seconds, so the velocity may be 10 meter per second. Okay, it means after some time interval, the velocity is changing at a cross section, say x axis. Okay? So it means we have v2 minus v1, t2 minus t1, so 10 minus 2 by 10. Get 0.8 around. So it means the velocity is changing. So we can write in mathematical form. So dou v by dou t is not equal to 0. Okay, like this. Similarly, you can write for all the things. So these are not equal to dou q by dou t, not equal to 0. Okay, not equal to 0. Likewise, you can write for all the flow properties, those are not equal to 0 with respect to time. So I hope you understood this, what is steady flow and unsteady, right? Yeah. So let me go to the next type of flow. So the next type of flow is what? So already we have seen steady flow, unsteady flow, then. So let me, before I go to the uniform and non-uniform flow, let me discuss about laminar flow and turbulent. Laminar flow. So I think it is very familiar with you, the terms now. So what is laminar flow? Anyone please define laminar flow, turbulent flow in simple words. See, you should not forget all these things.
The fluid particles which move in straight line is known as laminar, which move in zigzag manner, turbulent.
So when now this laminar flow, turbulent flow definitions will not change for any kind of case. It may be pipe flow, it may be open channel flow, or it may be flow through soils. Everywhere the definition means remains same. So laminar flow means the flow, but the flow will be in straight direction. Okay, the fluid particles travel in straight direction. Not even straight, you can say that they travel without intermixing. Okay, they travel without intermixing like this. So these are called, you know, laminar flow or streamline flow. They don't intermix with each other, it's called laminar. So turbulent flow means they will go like this. They will mix each other. Okay. So this kind of flow is called turbulent. So in general, you will not see this turbulent flow much in the open channel flow, because there won't be any kind of high pressure region. So simply traveling with gravity force. So you will not observe much the turbulent. Okay. So anyway, how do you classify? So there are, in this way, you can just define those, what is laminar flow and turbulent flow. So how do you classify based upon some quantity? What is a quantity? So how do you classify laminar flow and turbulent flow? What is a quantity you call? So in fact, you have done the, you have written the exam, the final exam also. What is the experiment? Okay, so based upon Reynolds number, okay, you can also classify the laminar turbulent. What is the formula for this? What is the formula about?
Rho Vd by mu.
So rho v d by mu. So when I am talking with respect to, you know, open channels, is this formula is correct? Or any thing we have to change in this particular formula?
Rho v l by mu.
So when we talk about with respect to open channels, so generally we have seen rho Vd by mu in case of pipes. Okay, in case of pipe flow we have seen. So, but we are talking about open channels. So what is the modified form of this Reynolds number for open channels? So in this four, we have density, velocity, diameter d, mu. In these four parameters, okay, so anything has to be changed, the parameter in this particular thing. L instead of d. Good. So we have to change, because we are talking about open channel, okay, open channel, so we have to change the diameter in with L, okay, we get rho V L by mu. Okay, so this is the formula to find, to classify laminar flow and turbulent flow in open channels. Okay, so don't confuse. Okay, it's very, very important. Rho V D by mu is pipe flow, rho V L by mu is the open channels, okay, the length of channel. Right? Okay, so now, same as we have seen in case of pipe flow, based upon some range, we have classified the types of flows. So in case of this, when RE less than how much? 2000. What type of flow is this? Laminar flow. When RE greater than 4000, it is called turbulent flow. So when value in between, that is called transition flow. So that we have seen in case of pipe. Okay. So you can also add this as one of the difference in our differences between open channel and pipe flow. You can add it as a fifth difference. Okay. Anyway. So now how to classify this open channel flow based upon this number. So when RE less than and RE less than, so 500. So why the value has reduced? Can anyone tell me? Here we are talking about 2000-4000 range, but when it comes to this open channel flow, where somewhat the Reynolds number has get reduced. Okay, less than 500, it is called laminar flow. Okay, when RE greater than 2000, okay, it is called turbulent flow, and when RE value in between, okay, so in between 500 and 2000, it is called transition flow. Transition means the flow either a laminar or turbulent, it is in between. Okay. So can you tell me why the value has decreased the Reynolds number? 500, 2000. Here it is 2000, 4000. Why it is decreased? Anyone? See, if you are talking about with respect to water, density will be remain same. Okay. Mu remains same. Only the diameter, velocity, the pipe flow. Velocity and length. Velocity here, diameter. So you can easily observe that, okay, in case of pipe flows, the velocity will be very high because we are applying pressure externally. Okay, so the velocity will be in general very high. Okay, and whereas the velocity in case of open channel flow will be somewhat less compared with the pipe flow. That is why the velocity somewhat get reduces compared to the velocity in the pipe flow. So that's why we are classifying Reynolds number with some lesser Reynolds quantity, okay, than this, because of the velocity differences between open channel and the pipe flow. Okay. So this is the classification of this laminar flow and turbulent flow in open channel. So please try to remember this. Okay, so just want to add one more point here is that it's your choice. Okay, it's your choice to note down the class notes while I am teaching. Okay, I'm not forcing to note down. It's your wish. If you want to note down, you can note down. Okay. So anyway, I'm going very slowly, so you can easily note down the class notes in your notebooks. Anyway. So this is the third classification, laminar flow and turbulent flow, right? So we have seen steady flow and steady flow. What is that other one? Yeah, laminar flow and turbulent flow. Okay, so next we'll discuss about, the third flow is called uniform flow and non-uniform flow. Okay, so this is actually very important type of flow, especially in open channels. Okay, so we add some more flows, some more categories in this uniform flow, non-uniform flow in open channels. Okay, very very important, we'll discuss that. Okay, so I think the time is almost 4 o'clock. Okay, so in the next class, I will discuss about this uniform flow and non-uniform flow is very, very important for exam point of view. Okay, we'll discuss this. Uniform flow, non-uniform flow in open channels. Okay. Anybody has got any doubts regarding the subject or any general questions? Okay, so if you don't have any doubts, then leave. We will discuss further in the next class. So thank you all.